Dear student, today we will discuss virus. The study of virus is called virology. Virus is a cellular nucleoprotein which lives as an intracellular obligate parasite. Now, what does this mean? Acellular means without cell wall, cell membrane and cell organelles, that is no cell is present. Nucleoprotein means combination of nucleic acid. Nucleic acid may be DNA or RNA and protein. Protein, actually they are polymer of amino acids. Different combination of amino acid form different types of proteins. Intracellular means within the cell. Obligate parasite means organism that cannot complete its life cycle without exploiting a suitable host. If obligate parasite cannot obtain a host, it will fail to reproduce and grow or multiply. So host is important for the survival of parasite. So what is host? Host is an organism that harbor a parasite. So host and parasite interaction is there in the virus, and virus, it cannot survive without host. Now let's understand why we say virus lives on the borderline of living and non-living, because they exhibit both the features. If you look at the living characteristic, just like living, they have genetic material and they are able to multiply genetic material, but their mode of multiplication is different. That is, they multiply their genetic material in suitable host. Now they can also be transmitted from one host to another. Okay, and they are sensitive to heat, chemicals and radiation. If you look at the non-living characteristic, they do not have cell. So there is no cell which is present. As we say, all the living beings are made up of cell, and they do not multiply outside the living body. So you cannot multiply them in laboratory, in the test tube. They are not multiplied on any of the non-living surface. They do not have self-metabolic machinery to multiply, such as there is no respiration that is taking place. Respiration is one of the important process which occur in all the cell, but virus, they do not do any respiration. So there is no metabolic machinery, and other metabolic processes are also absent. They can be crystallized and kept in bottle for infinite time. So if they are undisturbed without any host surrounding, then you can keep them for infinite time, and you can again revive them in presence of suitable host. Now if you look at the unique features of virus, they are smaller than bacteria. They are about 50 times smaller than bacteria. They do not follow cell theory. The body is made up of genetic material and protein. So let's discuss the body structure is made up of genetic material and protein. Protein coat, which is also called as capsid. Now genetic material could be DNA or RNA. If DNA is genetic material, then it is called deoxyvirus. If RNA is genetic material, it is called ribovirus. Now DNA could be double-stranded DNA or single-stranded DNA. And RNA could also be double-stranded RNA or single-stranded RNA. Now, double-stranded RNA, there exists two different variety. They may contain RNA virus or RNA DNA virus. Means what? When they enter the host, they form RNA copies in the host, and this is how they multiply. Whereas in case of RNA DNA virus, the virus basically contain RNA as genetic material, double stranded RNA as genetic material, but they enter the host and there they form DNA, and DNA is again converted back to RNA. This is very common in group of virus called retrovirus. Now look at the protein coat. It covers genetic, it encapsulates or covers the genetic material. It consists of subunit called caspomers. Caspomers are arranged in helical, polyhedral or other geometric forms. So different shapes of viruses, actually they depend on how the protein coat is arranged around the genetic material. Now virus are host specific. The virus which infect the bacteria may not infect the plant and animal. Okay, so they are highly specific to bacteria. Now the bacteria, the virus which infect the bacteria are called bacteriophage. Example, coliphage, which is infecting the E. coli. Similarly, plant, for example, tobacco mosaic virus, animal virus such as adenovirus. There are so many virus. Time to time we will see in the syllabus and study about them, their significance. Now let's look at the history of the virus. Now main contribution is by three different scientists. One is Dmitry Losifovic Ivanovsky, Martinus Vallam Bezernak, Wendell Meredith Stanley. Okay, now Ivanovsky, he was the first one to find out, let me tell you here, the first study was done on the tobacco mosaic virus. So he was the first one to find out the cause of tobacco mosaic disease in tobacco plant. Bezernak, he is known as father of virology, and he coined the term virus. He was the founder of virology and he discovered TMV, that is tobacco mosaic virus. And Stanley, he is the Nobel laureate, and he carried out crystallization of tobacco mosaic virus. We'll just see their contribution one by one. Now he did one experiment. Ivanovsky, he did one experiment. He prepared the extract of infected leaf of tobacco plant, allowed it to pass through a special filter which could trap the bacteria. So filter, the bacteria could not pass through, but this consists of virus, so virus could pass through the filtrate. The filtrate is checked for the bacterial infection. Earlier people were not knowing about the virus, so they thought that some bacteria is infecting the plant. So it was checked for the bacterial infection by spraying on the leaves of the healthy tobacco plant. The healthy plant was infected with tobacco mosaic disease, that is the spot disease of tobacco leaves. So he came to the conclusion that extract or filtrate contain infecting agent. Now this experiment was continued by Bezernak. The filtrate obtained by Ivanovsky was named as contagium vivium fluid, that is contagious living fluid. Now after repeating the experiment of Ivanovsky, he laid down his findings, and according to his findings, Bezernak said that virus diffuse through agar where bacteria form colony on agar. Means he tried to grow the virus on the culture medium which is made up of agar. Agar is a kind of polysaccharide, you can say, which is derived from red algae. Now this is usually used to culture the bacteria and fungi. They can grow over the surface of agar, but he found that bacteria could grow but virus cannot grow. So when he tried to grow this fluid, then he found that the virus, it diffused through the agar. The virus cannot be cultured without. And the second finding is that the virus, bacteria you can culture on the agar without any other requirement. Okay, just you have bacterial cells and they can be multiplied on agar. Whereas virus, it could diffuse through the agar, so you cannot culture it in the laboratory. Moreover, the virus require some living plant in order to form the, virus particles. He also discovered that virus are reproducing entity. It's not like that you cannot grow the virus. They are reproducing entities. So he was able to work out with how these virus could be grown and they require host. Viruses are different from other organisms. So these were the findings of Bezanek in short. Now we'll come to the Stanley. Now he was the one who carried out crystallization. Now what is crystallization? It is the process of transforming components of virus into organized particle and thereby describing their molecular structure using X-ray crystallography. So this is a method by which you can study the molecular structure of maybe the protein and the genetic material which is present in the virus. The study helped to identify the characteristic of virus, and he showed that TMV remain active even after crystallization. So for this he got the Nobel Prize. Now in short, I'll just go through TMV. TMV is a single-stranded virus. It causes tobacco mosaic disease, and this was first reported in 1882 by Adolf F. Mayer. Now it is rod shape and has 2130 caspomer, which form helical structure with hollow central. So this is just to give you brief idea about TMV. Now let's study the virus infectivity in the host. So how it causes infectivity? Now the virus is nucleoprotein, in which protein coat encapsulate the genetic material. It attack host cell by binding of its protein with the receptor on host cell. This is specific interaction, is very very specific. It take over, the virus take over the metabolic machinery of the host, such as enzymes, proteins, and replicate its own genetic material. Now the copies of nucleic acid forms in the host. The nucleic acid now start functioning and form protein coat around itself. The host cell now carry copies of virus. The virus lies the host cell and ready to infect the nearby cell. So you can look at the virus. You can see its genetic material. Let's call it as DNA and protein coat in helical shape. And this is the host cell. Now the virus attaches on the receptor of the host cell, gain the entry. Either the whole virus enter, or if it's genetic material or DNA enter, then also it is able to form the copies. Now this DNA is replicated, or its copies are formed in presence of the machinery of the host. So virus has no machinery. It utilizes the metabolic machinery of host. It multiplies. Okay. And again, DNA has an information to form the protein coat. So many viral particles are formed in the host cell. A time come, it will lyse the host cell, it will utilize everything in the host cell, and then number of virus particles are now ready to infect the nearby cell or whatever host is available. So this is how they are infecting. There are two important terms, one is viroid and another one is mycoplasma. Now viroid are different from viruses. They are infectious pathogen, consist of short stretch of circular RNA. They lack protein coat, mainly associated to infect the plant. We'll also see what are mycoplasmas. They are also known as PPLO, pleuropneumonia like virus. These are assumed to be linked between virus and bacteria. They are discovered by Louis Pasteur in 1845, and they contain RNA or DNA and has lipoprotein membrane without cell wall. That's why they change the shape easily. They also contain protoplasm and ribosome. They survive in extreme conditions such as lack of oxygen, hot springs, soil, sewage, everywhere. So this is how the mycoplasma, they are different from bacteria and so we cannot call them bacteria, and viroid, we cannot call them virus because they lack certain features. So this is all about virus. Thank you.